So we're gonna go ahead and start today's lesson. It's called Who Rules? But before we begin, I want to discuss filling out this chart. You should have it in your student materials. It's also available on my Moodle page. But when we're done, you are gonna fill out this chart with you're gonna write the forms of government, the different types of government you learn about in the PowerPoint in these boxes, and you'll put little check marks in these boxes according to if that feature is shown in that form of government. So we're going to discuss this more in class, but I do expect you to get as much of this filled out ahead of time as possible. I would also use the forward and back button on the video browser on this to go back and fill out that chart. So let's go ahead and get started with the PowerPoint lesson. It's called Who Rules? Forms of Government. So we're going to talk about the different forms of government, the different ways that government takes shape in people's lives. It says when people decide to form social contracts, we're going to talk about that's just basically an agreement between people to come together and to form a government. And here they make different decisions about how their government's going to look. So you can see, you can president or king. Are we going to be ruled by a few or by everyone? Are we going to hold elections? Where do rulers get their power from? All this is decided in the form of government. And we're going to talk about well, let's talk with the first about the first form of government, democracy. In democracy, it's a form of government in which political power is exercised by all citizens, either directly or through their elected representatives. So there are two kinds of democracies. There's what's called a direct democracy, and there's representative democracy, and we're going to talk about each of those right now. And you'll see that on your chart under democracy, there are two boxes. You're going to write direct, and you're going to write representative in those boxes. So let's begin with talking about direct democracy. In direct democracy, all citizens participate in government. There are no representatives in government. Everybody votes on everything. So on a Saturday, everybody meets up at the local hill, and all the citizens, whoever can vote, votes. Everybody votes on all laws. And all citizens can create public policy if they want to in a direct democracy. And the classic example of this is in ancient Athens, where everybody met at assemblies and voted to pass laws. And so in a representative democracy, again, the people rule, and all citizens participate in government. It's just the difference is how they participate. In a representative democracy, people elect representatives who vote on their behalf on laws for all citizens. So instead of each person voting on every law, we elect representatives who vote on our behalf. And then the key is that those representatives are held accountable to the people through regular. So if a person doesn't vote how you want them to vote in the government, you can vote them out of office if enough other people feel the same way. And the representatives are also held accountable by a constitution. We're going to talk much more about the United States Constitution, but a constitution is a set of rules that limit the power of the representatives. So that is a representative democracy. So a little review here, a little mental review here. Let's fill in some blanks. You can write this down on some paper if you want. What are the two forms of democracy? Write them down right now. Did you write direct and representative? That's what they are. Next one. In a democracy, all blank participate in government. In a democracy, all blank participate in government. It's citizens. All citizens vote on everything in what? Hint, either direct democracy or representative democracy. Which one has all citizens vote on everything? Direct democracy. In a direct democracy, there are no what in government. There is not any representatives in government. And finally, in a representative democracy, the representatives answer to the people through what? What keeps the representatives accountable to the people? Elections. All right. Well, that was some review of democracy. So now that we've talked about the different forms of democracy, there are other forms of government. Typically, what we're going to talk here is where only one person is in control of government. And that's called autocracy. Autocracy with an A. And you can see from the definition, this is a form of government in which political power is controlled by one person, such as a monarch, a dictator, or an emperor. So autocracy, meaning one with power. And there are two kinds of autocracies, just like there are two kinds of democracies. There's one ruled by a monarch and one ruled by a dictator. So a monarchy is where you have rule by kings and queens and princes and princesses. Sometimes they go by other names, but they're called monarchs, mono meaning one, one in charge, where power is passed down through blood. And, leaders usually gain power because their parents were rulers, and it passes down that way. And there are even some modern monarchies left that are controlled by constitutions like Spain, Japan, even England to some degree. At least there's still a Queen of England. We'll be talking more about monarchies. Now, the other form of autocracy is a dictatorship. And in a dictatorship, power isn't inherited, but it's acquired by force, either military or political. At the point of a gun, usually a dictator takes over power. Dictators have absolute control over the lives of their citizens, and usually people are not allowed to voice negative opinions against the dictator. Of course, probably the one of the more famous ones would be Adolf Hitler, right, of Germany during World War II. You'll learn about that next year. Today you have North Korea's leader, Kim Jong-il is considered a dictator. Although I believe it's his son now. Kim Jong-il, I believe, died, and his son has recently taken over since this PowerPoint was made. So, what else? Well, we've talked about democracies. Democracy is what? Rule by the who? By the people. All right? And autocracy is rule by the one. But there are other forms of government besides monarchies and, or excuse me, democracies and autocracies. There's government by the few, all right, by a few people. So not one person, but not many people, but rule by a few. And we're going to talk about those right now. First, there's something called an oligarchy, which really means rule by the few. In under an oligarchy, power can be based on several things: military strength, a family, particular family in power, or religious control. And oligarchies can often lead to autocracies. So you can see how you can go very easily from rule by few to rule of one individual. So that's an oligarchy. The other example is called a theocracy. And the word theo comes from the Greek meaning God. So a theocracy is government that gets its power from a higher authority, from God. Usually it's religious. Leaders, autocratic or oligarchic, are usually religious leaders, and society uses religious law to settle its disputes. There are some Islamic countries that are theocracy, like Iran. There's also the Vatican, which is actually its own separate state within Italy, and it's ruled by the Pope and the rules of the Catholic Church. So those are some modern day examples of theocracies. And then finally, there's one other form of government, and that's actually no government at all. It's called anarchy. All right? And you can see the caption there that says, then, who makes and enforces laws? In anarchy, there is no government to make or enforce laws. It's basically every person for themselves. What do you think that would be like?
So as you can see, there are lots of different kinds of governments out there. And there are also combinations of these things to make it even more confusing. What is government ruled by God and a few people called? So we're going to do a little review game here. You'll notice on your notes, it's called A and B. And I want you, we're going to go through these one at a time. I want you to circle the one that you think it is, and then you can check your answer. So, democracy. In democracy, do we have rule by everyone or rule by no one? Democracy, which one is that? You're going to circle A or B. Democracy is, of course, rule by everyone. Whether it's representative democracy or not. Direct democracy. Direct democracy. Do citizens elect people to vote, or are all citizens voting on everything? Which one is direct democracy? All right. I hope you circled all citizens vote on everything. As you can imagine, not a lot gets done in direct democracy if it's too big. That's why you don't see this very often today. All right, in representative democracy, are representatives appointed? That means does someone put them in their job, or are they elected through voting? Did you circle B? That's what the United States has. And we're gonna do that soon. All right, in an autocracy, is that rule by one or rule by a few? Is one person in charge or are there a few people in charge? Autocracy is rule by one. And in a monarchy, do monarchies ever have constitutions? This is a tough one. Or is power inherited? The right answer here is power is inherited. It's passed down through the family. There are some constitutional monarchies left, as well as some monarchies in the traditional sense, where the monarch has absolute rule. All right, what about a dictatorship? A, have total control, or B, always protect freedom of speech? What would you say is true about a dictatorship? In a dictatorship, the dictator has total control. It's usually very harsh and brutal. You'll definitely see examples of that throughout history. Now, an oligarchy. This one, A, can come in many forms, or B, power is always inherited. You can pause the video and go back and check your notes if you think that'll be helpful. It's good to test yourself in this way and know where your stuff is at in your notes. And this we have comes in many forms. There are lots of different examples, whether it's a military group or a family, could be many things. Religious authority. Speaking of theocracy, in a theocracy, power is taken through force, or power comes from a higher being, like a god. And the right answer is power comes from a higher being. Theo is Greek for God. Krasi is power. All right. And last one, anarchy. What is anarchy? It's everyone does what they want, or everyone follows the laws. What is anarchy an example of? And it's everyone does what they want. So, I hope you got all those right. Now we're going to do a little review, and you will notice in your notes, in your packet, a chart that looks like this. What I want you to do is at least get this side of the chart filled out right here. And if you can, I'd like to go through and follow the instructions at the top and put marks in the appropriate boxes. So if democracy has rule by few or one, you're going to put a plus sign there. Or is it ruled by representatives? Put a plus sign there. Anyway, the instructions are at the top. Give that a go, and I'll look it over in class tomorrow.